Just 10 days ago, I bought myself a MacBook Air, and could I have possibly picked a worse time? Because today, Apple bombarded me with reasons that this just ain't that great anymore, because the new MacBook Air is faster, prettier, and somehow also cheaper. That's right, my friends, the Apple Air event is over. We've got a new laptop, a new desktop, a new iPad, and even a new processor to talk about. And these announcements range from, quite compelling to industry changing. But how much Apple tax are you willing to pay for these shiny new toys? No, really, I'm genuinely wondering, so I know how much I should be charging our sponsor. Paperlike. Get the feel and stroke resistance of paper on your iPad with a Paperlike 2.1 screen protector. Thanks to their proprietary microbead technology called nanodots, it works just like paper. Check it out using our link in the video description. Before we even get started, let's do a quick refresher on Apple's branding in case you missed our video on Dell's rebranding, which featured a one-to-one ripoff. Currently, there are four generations of Apple Silicon, with the manufacturing process node, efficiency, and single-threaded performance increasing as we go from M1 to M4. Within each generation, there are base, Pro, Max, and Ultra tiers, with the number of processing cores, GPU performance, and the maximum amount of unified memory increasing as you go up. Or sometimes increasing within a tier, or decreasing. I don't know, it's complicated. What isn't complicated is the most exciting feature of the brand new MacBook Air. It's blue! Okay, seriously, the sky blue color. It's pretty nice looking. But for us, the bigger deal here is the upgrade to the M4 base processor. It's still passively cooled, which is likely to result in thermal throttling during heavy workloads, but under lighter conditions, this thing should absolutely fly. It's got 10 of Apple's latest ARM CPU cores and anywhere from 8 to 10 GPU cores depending on the configuration. As for unified system memory, Apple is continuing their recent purging of 8GB systems from their lineup, so we get 16GB in the base config. But, like the rest of their lineup, if you want any more than that, you need to be ready to pay for it. And I'm talking more by weight than literal gold, with an additional 16GB of memory costing an obscene $400 upcharge. In fairness, I guess part of that goes towards a small GPU upgrade, but still. The webcam also gets an upgrade to the 12MP center stage camera that we saw in last year's MacBook Pro refresh. It supports automatic reframing to keep you from accidentally leaning out of the shot. And it supports desk view, a trick where you can duct tape your iPhone to the top of your laptop and turn it into an alternate second feed in video conference software like FaceTime and Zoom. The M4 processor on these new machines supports up to 2 displays, that is, on top of the built-in one, and the new machine keeps intact all of the things that already made the MacBook Air great, including its aluminum unibody, Touch ID, 500 nit liquid retina display, and Wi-Fi 6E. And as a bonus, Apple actually dropped the starting price to $1,000. Okay, it's a little on the iterative side, but if you were shopping for a Mac, it's still pretty exciting. Though not nearly as exciting as the new Mac Studio, where we get upgraded M3 and M4 chips. Now, one of these is faster than the other, and I'm gonna give you a second to guess. Did you say M3? Well, if you did, you're right. Wait, what? How does that work? Well, it's simple. Apple took 2 of their M3 Max chips and glued them together using what they call Ultra Fusion. This technology is similar to AMD's Infinity Fabric, where they use a silicon interposer between the 2 CPU dies and join them together to make them appear in software as a single discrete chip. This trickery allows the top M3 Ultra SKU to have a whopping 32 CPU cores and 80 GPU cores, along with a 32-core neural engine. So yeah, a single M4 core might be a little faster than a single M3 core, but when you've got that many of them, oh, is it ever fast. It won't come cheap though. If you want an M3 Ultra, the minimum memory config is 96GB. Though, if we're being realistic, most of the buyers of this machine are gonna take more because while Apple talks about improvements to dynamic caching and hardware accelerated mesh shading and ray tracing, The Mac Studio is clearly designed from the ground up to be an AI monster of a machine, where being able to load your entire model into memory can be hugely beneficial, especially in systems where that memory can be allocated between the CPU or, more likely, the GPU, depending on your needs. And you'll be running some seriously big models on this machine, thanks to Apple offering configurations with up to half a terabyte of RAM on the Mac Studio. That is, as long as you're okay paying an extra $4,800 for the privilege. Speaking of expensive upgrades, you can also equip the Mac Studio with up to a 16 terabyte SSD for also $4,800, bringing the top config up to an eye-watering $14,099. It kind of feels like Apple took the criticism that the Mac Pro was overpriced compared to the Studio and thought, well, we could discount the Mac Pro, or, hear me out, we could jack up the Studio. Anybody? Now, in fairness, the base version of the new Mac Studio isn't that outrageously priced, starting at $2,000 for an M4 Max chip with 14 CPU cores and 32 GPU cores and 36 gigs of unified memory. It's about the same as what you'd find in the current-gen MacBook Pros. But as seems to be typical for Apple these days, that starting price quickly balloons as you start to option out your machine. You want more RAM? Oh, well, you'll need to shell out for 8 extra GPU cores, just to unlock the privilege of spending $200 for just 12 gigabytes of RAM. Ouch. There is some more good news, though. Every Mac Studio now comes with 4 Thunderbolt 5 ports for blazing fast 80-ish gigabit connectivity, a 10 gig Ethernet port, and on the M3 Ultra, you can connect up to 8 displays simultaneously to build the ultimate Mac granddaddy of a battle station. For those of you looking for something a bit more touching, though, we also got new iPad Airs. The key upgrade here is an M3 processor with 8 CPU cores, 9 GPU cores, and 8 gigs of RAM. Apple claims that compared to an older M1 iPad Air, you can expect 35% faster CPU performance in multi-core loads and 40% faster GPU performance. Apple also has a new Magic Keyboard for the iPad, which connects magnetically and has a larger built-in trackpad. Now, I'm told that the price actually went down on these accessories, but good Lord, are they ever not cheap. At $269 and $319 for the 11 and 13-inch keyboard respectively, like, does Apple not know how incredible of a keyboard you can get for $320? Anywho, this means that, as usual, if you just want a tablet, the iPad Air is actually a pretty darn decent value, especially given that Apple hasn't increased the price over last gen. It's just that once you add in a keyboard and a stylus, you are getting dangerously close to a base MacBook Air, which gets double the RAM, double the storage, more cores, not to mention a real operating system. I think you can all guess which one I would choose. Our biggest surprise from this event, though, was that Apple was able to deliver price cuts to the MacBook Air and the Magic Keyboard despite the tariffs that the current US administration is imposing, which will impact the price of electronics more broadly. This has led to some speculation that the new MacBook Air might be made in Malaysia or in Vietnam to avoid tariffs on Chinese-made goods, but we won't know for sure until we have them in hand for our short circuit unboxing video. So maybe act fast if you're looking for a new laptop, or if you're looking for a new segue to our sponsor, Paperlike. If you thought that nothing can replace that sketchbook you carry around with you, think again. Transform your iPad into the ultimate writing and drawing companion with Paperlike 2.1, a uniquely designed screen protector that uses a proprietary microbead technology called nanodots to emulate the stroke resistance of real paper. It lets display light shine around and through the screen protector with minimal refraction, so you get optimal picture quality and little to no glare, meaning you can do other stuff on your iPad too when it's time to take a break. They even have a 100-day satisfaction guarantee, so if you're not completely satisfied or you messed up while putting it on, you can get a free replacement or refund. Pick yours up today using our link in the video description. If you guys enjoyed this video, maybe go check out our announcement video for the iPhone 16e. I had some controversial takes, but I stand by them.